Throughout this Breeders' Crown Series, we've been talking with drivers about the different strategies involved with each race, be it on a different size track, a different type of racing surface, or with a different horse. Well, tonight at Liberty Belle, there is yet another strategy involved because there are 10 fillies in this race. At Liberty Belle, the rule is they have 8 on the gate. That means there will be 2 starting from the second tier. Post positions number 9 and 10 will line up between horses number 1 and 2. Because of that, there are driver strategies, not only for those on the back row, but those on the first row.
Depending on the horses, these are 3-year-old fillies and they've raced quite a lot, so you're not going to experience quite so much trouble with the horses breaking one thing or another. But younger horses, and on a half-mile track, the two tiers is a lot more dangerous than it is on even the 5/8 or the mile. But personally, I'm in favor of them all being on the gate, but in a case like this, it just isn't practical, so we have to go with the two tiers.
It kind of messes up the race for everyone when there's trailers behind the horses on the gate. Everyone from the outside thinks they have to leave to get a better position. They take back and they get 9th or 10th. It's just kind of too many horses on this size track.
Well, and behind you just got to hope that the one you're following can keep up. And sooner or later, you know, if they double tier them and you're caught down in two or three of them cross over in front, well, you know, shortens your chances up of getting out. But when they got like 9 horses here tonight, it shouldn't be too bad.
The driver in post position number 9 must stay behind the number 1 horse. He has to stay on the rail as approaching the gate. Now, in post position number 10, the driver has the option. He can stand behind the horse number 2, or he can drift outside if he pleases. That will probably not be the case tonight because the favorites are right on the rail. Naughty But Nice and Hit Parade, so it is doubtful that John Campbell will try to veer outside too much. And it should be interesting that the 9 and 10 horses will probably have an advantage tonight over the horses on the outside because they will have early positioning because they're behind the speed horses, behind the favorites. Things should shape up by the 8th mile. It will be interesting to see, though, Mylan Hanover in position number 5 because she's right in the middle of things. She will have 6 horses because of those 2 drifters behind her instead of 4 horses to beat out at the early going. The racing strategy should shape up, as usual, by about the quarter mile.
And thank you, Kenny.